welcome. Good morning to another day of working out early in the morning in the cold. Thanks for showing up. Nice job. Let's start moving. Side shuffle. Here we go. Walk this out or hop it out. Again, always with the sideways stuff. That's just what we do. Okay, so today we're going to do a really nice, fun squat exercise paired with a shoulder lateral raise exercise. Lateral raises work really well with either no weight or just really small weights. I'm going to do something different because I think last time or the time before, I might have suggested to you guys, hey, try a heavier weight, see what happens. And then I just keep sticking with the light stuff. So what I'm going to do is go with something twice as heavy as I normally use for a lateral raise, just to see what happens. 3, 2, 1, come on out, walk out the butt kickers. And so what's going to happen is by the end of the time that we do it, I'm not going to go up as high as I started with. And it's also probably going to hurt a little bit, but I'm going to focus on keeping my intent solid, nice, smooth movements. I'm not going to start flailing. I'm not going to start throwing the weight up just to get it up higher because that leads to injury. I'm going to try to do it right. Okay, let's turn this into a jog if it's there for you. Ready and go. And if it's not, then don't. Are you practicing congratulating yourself for showing up? Hopefully, you got to do that. Oh. Okay, so whether you're walking this or jogging this, let's just speed it up. You can speed it up with walking. Okay, keep those knees down, heels kick up. 3, 2, 1, come on out. Perfect. Let's get the shoulders warmed up. So let's bring them maybe level with the ground, but if that feels a little bit creaky for you, you can have them below level. So whatever level you're at, it's going to stay that way. And all I want you to do is bring the arms forwards, squeeze the hands together, and then open them. And then open them as far behind as you can without dropping the hands and without raising the shoulders. Okay? So forwards and squeeze as hard as you want. Open and squeeze the shoulder blades together. Close and squeeze, open and squeeze the shoulder blades. Your face should look straight forwards, chin slightly tucked. When the arms go back, you do not reach your face forwards. You just keep it where it is. This is nice and slow, warming up those shoulders. If the arms don't like to be so high, this can be done at a much lower angle. And you can actually just try different positions as you do each repetition here. Nice and slow and controlled. You're choosing how hard to squeeze your hands together, and you're choosing how vigorously to squeeze your shoulder blades together. All right. We're doing 3 more of these. This is a type of warm-up exercise that creates a lot of heat, and it's also really safe. I've lost track of how many I said when I said 3 more. So I'm going to stop now. All right, let's do arm circles. You pick the size and the speed. Just making your arm circles go around and around with your elbows stiff and your stomach held tight. Okay. That's it. Just a nice controlled shoulder motion. Doesn't matter how big the circles are. They could be really big if that's what you like, or just tiny. Whatever works. Let's change direction. Yeah, nothing goofy about this. We're just doing this in the way that works for us. Keep breathing. 3, 2, 1. Now we want to warm up the hips. We haven't done too much of that yet for our squats, so let's just do a nice reverse lunge. Step back, swing the arms to the front, touch the fingers. Might as well keep with this shoulder movement deal, right? You get to choose how far back you go and how low you go. Sometimes in the motion, if the motion involves your whole body and therefore gets a little bit maybe complicated for you at 8 o'clock in the morning, if you just rolled out of bed 10 minutes ago and your body is wondering what's happening. Speaking of wondering what's happening, I totally lost my train of thought there. I was probably going to say something really important. And then, and it may never come back. I'm doing one more and then stopping. Come on out. Perfect. Grab some water. Let me show you the deal. So I've got a 30 second clock. 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off. What I want us to do is body weight squats. So hinge and sit, okay? Hinge and sit for 30 seconds. I want all of us to go not too slow, but I want you to count how many you do. Here's the key, count how many you do. For round two, we want to do a little bit more. And for round three, a little bit more yet. Okay, so count. Don't start off super slow and sandbag this thing. Do it properly, right? But then we're gonna push it and go faster and faster. All right, so a 30 second rest. In between these kind of squat progressions, we're gonna do a nice lateral raise. So it's gonna be 30 seconds, and the goal is to just lift it up and put it back down, lift it up and put it back down. I'm gonna try heavier weight than I normally should use, just to see what happens, just for fun. I thought, what the heck? With that exercise, one of your goals, when the arms go up, the shoulders don't. There's no shrugging, okay? And I really want your head to stay where it's supposed to be, not reaching or twisting or turning, okay? That's the plan. Let's get her going. So starting with body weight squats, don't go slow, don't go too fast, and you're counting. Ready, set, begin. You're counting. Exhaling as your eyes. Over, that's halfway there. Five seconds to go. Three, two, one, rest. Okay, note that number. The next time we get to it, I want you to try to do one or two or three more. Oh, I won't talk very much, just so we don't lose track of our counting. Yeah, I heard you cheer there, actually. Good job. Nice. Yes, I'm going to stop talking. Okay, grab your weights for lateral raises. 30 seconds is quite a long time to do this. So get ready. Three, two, one, begin. Slow and controlled. If you have a really light weight and you want to make it just a little bit harder on yourself, pause at the top for a moment and then put it back down. Exhaling as you rise. Yikes. Rest. Thank goodness. That was getting hard. Okay. Nice. That's one round done. Two to go. Remember your number for squats? You're doing more this time. And we only have one round after this. Let's see. No, let's... You know what? We're going to do four rounds of this. Yeah, we'll do four rounds. So plan for that. Okay. Ready? Three, two, one. Squat. Here we go. Nice job. That's halfway. Yep, pick it up now. Five seconds. Three, two, one. Rest. Did you do it? I hope so. Okay. Lateral raises. We slow this down again. We're not doing more and more and more with this one. We're just surviving, okay? Think of lateral raises as a really good opportunity. One word. To hold your tummy tight the whole time. All right, grab those weights. Three, two, one. And go. Don't swing them. Lift them. Exhale as you rise. back of the hand should point to the ceiling, not the thumb. Three, two, one, rest. Perfect. That heavy weight's not killing me. I kind of thought it would. Maybe I've just been mailing it in all this time. That's sometimes what we find out. Okay, in 10 seconds, squats. Your goal, more than last time. Ready in 5 seconds. Three, two, one, squat. You better start faster from the beginning if you're gonna do more. This means your breathing speeds up because you want to exhale on the rise. If you don't need that much air, take smaller breaths, more shallow breaths. Okay, 5 seconds. Three, two, one, rest. Good job. Now maybe you need all the air you can get because this is hard. So big breaths. But fast, you're exhaling on the way up, every time. Okay, lateral raise coming up. Perfect, okay, grab your weights. Three, two, one, go. Nice and slow and controlled. Always, the first rep I do, I always feel I'm just flailing it around. So that instruction is as much for me as for anybody. Exhale as your eyes. Oh, come on. Three, two, one. Rest. Perfect. We might put a little bonus lateral raise thing at the end here. Okay, so this is our last squat. If you've been less than successful at speeding up, this is your last chance to redeem yourself. this is star time. This is the money. This is where it counts. Three, two, one, and go. This might be as fast as you can go. You got to get a higher number. Actually, truth is, it doesn't really matter, right? Who cares? But, well, you do. You know what you're doing. Crank it out. Don't make the motion smaller. Just past halfway here. Full motion, all the way up and down. 5 seconds. Three, two, one. Oh, whew, stop. You do it. I hope so. For your sake. All right, lateral raises. Last one, slow, controlled, powerful. 10 seconds. God, doing this huffing and puffing is hard, right? Okay, three, two, one, go. Exhale as you rise. Only 9 seconds to go. And three, two, one, and rest. Okay, put those weights close by, put them down, shake out the shoulders. We got a 30-second rest bonus round. All we're gonna do is take those weights that we've been lifting. I'm gonna breathe. And we're gonna do one rep, lift and hold. Maybe it's level, maybe it's not quite level. We're just gonna hold. Hold the tummy tight, hold the shoulders tight. In three, two, one, like your life depends on it, go. Hold. Try smiling. Come on, here we go. When you're gonna give up slowly. Let the weights come down slowly. Oh my God, I don't know what's happening with you guys. Okay, I've quit. Are you still going? Keep going. I bet somebody's still going. Come on. Dig it in. 3, 2, 1. Okay, you may quit. It'd be kind of funny if we all quit like 15 seconds ago and I'm just talking to the screen, right? But no one knows that. Not gonna lie, in my pretend world here, all of you crushed that out right to the end of the 30 seconds, so good job. That's how I see it. All right, grab some water, rest, get ready for part B. Part B is gonna be as fun as part A. That's if part A wasn't any fun at all. It's the same. Same amount of fun. Where is my thing here? This one? No. Looking for a pyramid interval thing. So we're going to do a pyramid workout. It's going to be 30 seconds rest all the time. We're going to start with 20, and then 30, then 40, then 50, then 40, then 30, then 20. I think that's our work amount. And the exercise of choice is just a plain old plank. Okay, that's it. Just a plank. So you may choose one way to do a plank. So the most vigorous position is hands under shoulders on your toes and you're holding. To make that quite a bit easier, go on your knees. And another option, and my favorite one, is to have your hands on a stool. Even if it's like 5 inches off the floor, makes a big difference. Chair, back of a chair, the wall works, okay? So we're doing this for different lengths. You may choose your way of doing it for each interval length, or you may choose a harder version for 20 seconds and then move to an easier version for the 50 and back to harder for 20. I'll let you figure that out. Change how you're doing it just to survive it. And then we're all just gonna have as much fun as everybody else, okay? Alrighty, I got the timer going. So in 8 seconds, we get into our plank. Ready in 3, 2, 1, plank. This one's 20 seconds. All right, 20 seconds, breathing. This is where that neighbor that watches you, they're just wondering what you're doing, like nothing's happening, like you're frozen, right? 3, 2, 1, rest. Perfect. So when we go to rest, resist the urge to worry about the next interval and just focus on this 30 seconds, because this is the best part where we just get to do nothing and rest. Go into recovery mode. And then in 10 seconds, flip the switch, go into beast mode. Okay, 3, 2, 1, plank. This one's for 30 seconds. Nice job. You may also be on your elbows if your wrists and hands just don't like this. On your elbows is completely okay. Okay, we're halfway there. We're holding and we're breathing. We're loving life. So happy we showed up. 3, 2, 1, rest. Perfect. Okay, 30 second rest. Totally rest. Breathe. Might even close your eyes, meditate a little bit, pretend everything's fine. This next one's 40 seconds. Or twice as long as the first one. In 3, 2, 1, plank. Here we go. This format of doing a pyramid is maybe one of the more useful kind of self-directed methods to help you get stronger, to get better, okay? It's just a way to trick yourself into trying to do a little bit more than maybe you thought you could. Okay. All right, 10 seconds to go. I'm still having fun though. Oh yeah. In 3, 2, 1, rest. Perfect. All right. Full recovery mode. Breathe. Let everything just wash away. Not holding any tension, just letting it fly, letting it float. I imagine when some of those Olympic folks are at the top of the ski hill and they're getting ready to go, they just have to, especially with like slalom and stuff, they just got to relax. Okay, 3, 2, 1, plank. Okay, this is the long one, or the longest one, 50 seconds. That's right. This is why you showed up today. This is why you're here, to see if you can do this. If you're thinking, man, this is so easy, how can we make this harder? Start lifting a leg up and down. Just bend a knee like we did last time. Just kind of go back and forth like that if you want. I'm going to stop doing that because we have quite a bit of work to do yet. But if you want to, you can do that. 15 seconds to go. Since I'm on camera, I don't want to collapse. It makes the video look bad. It's hard to edit that out. 3, 2, 1, and relax. Okay, breathe, recover. Yeah, we've done that. And if you just do like a 10 second plank and loop it five times for 50 seconds. Watch for the video sometimes. See if you catch us doing that. It's like, okay, everybody, holding a plank for a minute. But we only do it 10 seconds and loop it. Okay, 3, 2, 1, plank. Now we're going downside on the pyramid. So we're 40 seconds this time. 40 seconds. So my heartbeat sound. We fell in love. As the leaves. Yeah, so if I recorded this just for YouTube without it being live and you guys watching me, that's what I'd do. Okay, just tiny something little, and then just loop it. Be careful what I say each time, right? So it doesn't sound obvious. 10 seconds to go. 5, 3, 2, 1, rest. Oh, I bet we're crushing this out. Okay, so we got a 30 and then a 20. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Right now we have to rest. Are you feeling Olympic? Are you feeling like, I don't know, I watch all the Olympics. Well, not all of them, sorry, that would be impossible, but some pieces, and I just get all jacked, and I think I'm one of them. Okay, 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Pop it up, and plank. This one's for 30. This one's 30. Keep breathing all the way in, all the way out, past the halfway mark. Five, 3, 2, 1, down, perfect. Okay, so this is so you're resting. One of the really cool things about doing a pyramid like this, I think, is that it kind of makes you feel strong, right? So that last one was only 30 seconds. Cool, crushed it out. This one's only 20. Now, I feel strong with it because I'm succeeding till the end. Now, if you're failing before the end, then maybe it's the opposite. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Only 20 seconds. Feel strong. Only 20. Only 15 left. Oh, we're almost done already. And that's 10 seconds. Only 10 seconds left. Feel the strength. 5, 3, 2, 1. Rest. Collapse to the floor or pop up and walk it out. Nice job. That last one is so short. I just hope that everybody could do that successfully and build that self-belief. Because that's where it's at. That's where it's at. I've seen people with very, very, very limited physical ability, but all the belief in the world, and they just have fun doing stuff. They just feel like they're doing really well. Okay, hop up if you're not up yet. Let's do a quad stretch. Oh, so I'm going to choose to lean against the wall because I'm tired. Let's put a foot into one hand. And what I want to do is squeeze the knees and then kind of tuck the bum in. So I'm kind of pushing my pelvis forwards, but still standing up tall with my chest up and back. Again, squeezing the knees and just putting a really nice gentle stretch on the quads. Those squats we did, especially when we go fast, hit the quads pretty good. All right, 3, 2, 1, and switch sides. So with a stretch like this, again, squeeze the knees, tuck the bum in, push the pelvis forwards, and then stand tall. So you're using your arm, which isn't very big, to stretch your leg, which is a lot bigger. So it might feel like a lot of work. This is what I would suggest, especially at the end of a workout. Don't try that hard. Don't worry about it. Do you feel the stretch in your quad? Maybe. Maybe you don't. Honestly, it doesn't matter. It's still working. 3, 2, 1, and switch sides. Same thing on the first side. All right, squeeze the knees. That's really important. I'm just using my shoulder to shrug up, to pull up on my foot. And then I'm remembering to breathe, because I got a bunch of stuff going on. And I just sometimes forget that while we're stretching, we should be breathing. Three, two, one, and come on out. Let's switch sides, same thing on side two. Squeeze the knees, shrug, and enjoy. And 3, 2, 1, come on out. And let's do another stretch. So for the hip, for the glute, I'm going to lean against the floor or wall with my left hand, left ankle across right knee, left ankle across right knee. And I'm going to reach my bum backwards, and my belly is going to fit into this little triangle. My left knee is trying to open up as far as possible. Toes inside my left shoe are raised just to protect my left knee. And I'm just realizing that this is something I haven't done in a while. Cannot believe how bad this feels. I'm mildly concerned right now. 3, 2, 1, come on out. Maybe the other side's better. Let's see. Right ankle across left knee. Nope. That might even be worse. Okay, when this video is over, I'm going to be spending a little more time on this stretch. My goodness. Toes inside your right shoe are lifted. 3, 2, 1. I'm going to come out of that. And I'm going to spend a little more time on that. You may choose to also. But with that, that's our workout for Thursday morning. Thanks for showing up. I appreciate it. And so does your body. I will see you next week.